prophet, because Nabi means prophet. So he was selected to be the first Khalifa of the Muslims, or the first ruler of Muslims, the first person who is leading, the first leader who is leading the Muslims after the death of Prophet Muhammad. His rule lasted for 2 years and 3 months. And during his Khalifate, he fought successfully against false prophets and others who tried to break Ummah. Ummah means the Islam nation. The nation of Muslims is called Ummah. And this is also in Arabic, by the way. Because after the death of Prophet Muhammad, many people tried to revert or tried to... some people, they claimed that they are prophets, and they were false prophets, of course, because we know that Prophet Muhammad is the last prophet. So he fought those people because they were wrong, and he wanted all the people to follow the true path of Prophet Muhammad and the true path of Islam. Abu Bakr was a true believer and servant of Allah. He was a true follower of Prophet Muhammad. Abu Bakr Siddiq was a kind-hearted man. Yeah, he was very kind-hearted and very well-mannered. He defended Islam firmly and faithfully and was loved by all his people. He lived a simple, pious, and upright life. Okay, now we move to the last part of our class, which is the questions, choice questions. Number one, Abu Bakr was younger than the Prophet by... how many years? 2 years, 3 years, 5 years? Of course, 2 years. Number two, Abu Bakr was given the title Khalifatul Nabi, Amirul Mu'mineen, Amirul Islam. Of course, it is the first one also, Khalifatul Nabi. Number three, Abu Bakr's Khilafat or Khalifat lasted for over 3 years, over 2 years and 3 months, over 10 years. It is the second answer, over 2 years and 3 months. Number four, Abu Bakr accompanied the Prophet in all the battles, or Uhud, the battle of Uhud only, or Al-Khandaq, the battle of Khandaq only. Actually, the answer is all the battles, as we mentioned in explaining the lesson. All the battles. Number five, Abu Bakr was a nephew of Rasulullah, a father-in-law of Rasulullah, a secretary of Rasulullah. Of course, he was not a secretary. He was not the nephew of Rasulullah. But he was a father-in-law of Rasulullah, of Prophet Muhammad. Rasulullah means Prophet Muhammad. Because his daughter, Aisha, she was married to Prophet Muhammad. He gave her to Prophet Muhammad in marriage. That's why he was the father-in-law of Prophet Muhammad.